I was at the U of I, and you know, when you're on a young baseball, let's talk baseball. When your kid's playing baseball, your best player is your pitcher. Yeah. Pitcher is your best hitter, your best, you know, the pitcher is the best. When you are a young actor in college, if you're a good actor, you end up playing the old men. You play the old men. So I played a lot of old men in college and at the U of I. And so I was playing an 86-year-old physicist in Tom Stoppard's jumpers, and the makeup department just sprayed my hair with streaks and tips every day. Every day for the, so it was gray. I'd look like either a large transvestite or Granny Clampett, you know, big Granny Clampett. I did not look like an old man. But what happened was, the day this show ended, I went to the shower, my shower, to wash out the streaks and tips, and my hair fell out in handfuls. Like I walked through a room of plutonium. It just came out in handfuls, and I was crushed. I thought, like, this is it for me. And I came out to Los Angeles, and I would see casting directors look at my hairline. You know, they wouldn't look at my, they'd look, okay. They're casting Grease at the time, the movie Grease, and go, yeah, okay. You're not gonna have any bald greasers. You know, you're gone. So it was crushing. But then I found out that there's only one leading man in a movie, like Bill Murray, one leading man. But every leading man has a doctor, a lawyer, a school principal, an old friend, a police detective that's chasing him down. So there's so many more opportunities to work and act if you're a character actor. And it's much more of a detective job than being a lead actor. Lead actors get to do everything in the movie, right? You get to see them wake up in their pajamas and shower and brush their teeth and eat breakfast and the orange juice. When you're a character actor, you've done the same things, but you don't do them on camera. So you have to think through what the life is of your character, and it's very challenging. So I actually think I was lucky. Hey, I was lucky I lost my hair, like I was lucky I broke my neck. It's like, never trust a catastrophe, because it will turn into a blessing before your very eyes. So it was one of the best things that happened to me. Yes.